No limit in the sky that I won't fly for ya. No amount of tears in my eyes that I won't cry for ya. Hey guys, it's me, JSHDIY, and welcome back to the Happy Side of YouTube. Today, I'm going to be testing out some water slime recipes, but really quick, I wanted to first of all say that I am going to be doing a face reveal at 250,000 subscribers, so subscribe now if you haven't already.
Notification squad shoutouts today go to Fasing Xiao,
King Duck, and also Jocelyn Gonzalez.
So if you watch the whole entire video start to finish and you comment notification squad, it will actually come up first to me and I will be able to actually give you a shout out guaranteed. So watch the whole entire video if you want a guaranteed shout out.
For this first recipe, you're going to need some clear Vaseline body lotion, some water, some hair gel, any hair gel will work for this recipe, and you're going to be needing some cream of tartar to activate your slime. Starting off, you're going to need to add in a tablespoon of your clear Vaseline body lotion. And then you want to add in a tablespoon of your hair gel. Now you're going to be needing some water, and the recipe said to add in 2 teaspoons of water to your hair gel Vaseline mixture, so I did so because I didn't want to mess up this recipe. I was super careful about measuring it. And then you want to mix this up really well. The better you mix it, the better it will activate in a minute. To color this slime, I'm going to be using a marker because it's a no food coloring recipe. So you just want to cut open the marker, take out the little ink cartridge, and squeeze the ink out into your mixture, and it will color your slime. And to activate the slime, we're going to be using cream of tartar like the recipe showed. So I added in a little bit, let it sit for an hour. And then the recipe said to put it in the refrigerator for 45 minutes. So I left it in the refrigerator and I put it on a timer. And this is what it looks like, you guys, after 45 minutes. Now, this is what the slime looks like. I wasn't sure if it would work. And then I pulled out the little spoon thing and I realized that it kind of was like this jelly texture. And when I poked it, it was really cold, but it did kind of feel like a soapy slime. It kind of felt like soap slime, to be honest. It was really sticky, but this recipe was a success. I was super happy that this recipe worked out. This next recipe I'm going to be testing is a shampoo slime recipe. So you're meaning the Pantene Clear Shampoo as well as the Herbal Essence Shampoo. And I'm just using this rose one because that's the one I could find. And you're going to need some water and salt and baking soda to activate it. So starting off, you just want to take your salt, add a little bit. I don't know why I added it into this container. I just don't want to add too much. Add a little to your bowl and then add a few pinches of baking soda into that mixture as well. Now all you have to do is mix that up really well so that it doesn't overactivate our slime. And then you want to add in your water, and this is kind of like a miniature activator, like borax activator a little bit, but it's different because it's salt and baking soda. Now you want to start off by adding in your Herbal Essence soap, and you don't need to mix that yet because now we're going to be adding in the Pantene shampoo. And I'm not sure how you guys say that. Is it Pantene or Pantene? Comment down below. And then you just want to mix that up, and it should kind of start to activate a little bit because that salt and the baking soda has a reaction with the shampoo. It did work, but I did have to keep adding in more salt for it to actually become kind of slime-like. It kind of felt like you're holding dish soap in your hand, but it wasn't, obviously, because it was shampoo. I did leave it out for a few hours, and this is what it looked like after that. It wasn't a lot less sticky, but it did feel a little more thick and a little more like slime. So this recipe was definitely successful. For the next one, you're going to be needing some holdable bubbles. I just got these ones from the Dollar Tree. You're also going to be needing some water and some hand sanitizer. I saw this recipe on an Instagram slime tutorial, and I was super curious, so we're going to be testing it right now. This hand sanitizer I just got at Target, and it contains aloe. A lot of you guys say that your hand sanitizer has to contain aloe for it to work. Then you're needing some holdable bubbles. It just seemed like normal, but it was marketed as holdable bubbles. So basically you can hold it in your hand, add in a little of that, and then you want to add in your water. Add an even ratio of the water to the bubbles, and then you just want to stir that all up and then put it in the refrigerator for 45 minutes, just like the last recipe. And it has been 45 minutes now, you guys. I'm just gonna take it out and we're gonna take it back to the little set. Okay, you guys, this is what it looks like.
It does not look like slime. I feel like all the hand sanitizer recipes fail for me. I don't know why. Tell me in the comments if that happens to you guys too. For the next one, you're going to be needing some aloe and some Irish Spring shampoo. So starting off, you're just going to need to add in your shampoo. I'm using the Irish Spring one because you guys told me to use it for a slime. And then you're going to be needing to add in aloe. I thought this was perfect because the aloe vera I picked out at Target matched it because it was green. And then you want to add in a little bit of water. Give that a nice stir. And it's supposed to turn into slime, but it really didn't. You guys commented this recipe, and I'm not sure why I failed at this one, but as you guys can see, I put it in my hand. It totally wasn't slime. So sadly, that recipe was a fail. For the next one, you're going to be needing some Vaseline, some alum, and some water. And this recipe seemed unusual. I think I saw it on a channel called Toys Channel. And you're going to be needing some salt as an activator. So starting off, you're going to need to scoop some of your Vaseline out of the container. And this was honestly so satisfying. It seemed like one of those Instagram videos. I just scooped out some with this little popsicle stick and I added it into my bowl. It was really hard to like scoop off of the popsicle stick. I have no idea why, you guys, but I think it was just because it was like a thick texture. And then you're going to need your alum, and this is one of our activators. It basically dries up the soap. So add in that and give it a stir, and then add in some salt. And then you just want to stir this mixture all together. Make sure it's really well combined so that you don't like over activate your slime. And then you're gonna need to add in some water, and this kind of is like an activator solution, I guess you could say, but it's a lot more thick because you have the Vaseline in it as well. Mix it up really well, and then you're gonna need some dish soap, and you're gonna add some of that into your mixture. And I added in so much more salt, you guys, to this mixture, so I feel like that's why it worked. But when I added in the dish soap, I could literally start seeing it turn into slime before I even mixed it. And when I mixed it, I could see it, like, literally just, like, I don't know how to explain it, but it just, like, thickens up and turns into slime. It looks so cool, and the one problem I have with this is it isn't totally clear because of the Vaseline. I'm not sure exactly what the Vaseline does, but it did feel really good, and I feel like the Vaseline did make it a little thicker, so this recipe was definitely a success. This next recipe was sent to me by an Instagrammer called slime.acro, so go follow. For this recipe, you're going to be needing some water, some dish soap, and some salt. It seems simple, so I'm excited to try it out. Starting off, I just added in my dish soap, and then it said to add in your water, and then you want to add in your salt. This was a specific order, and she said you have to do it in this specific order for it to work. I was not thinking it would work. She said it would actually make a jiggly slime too, and I have never made a no-glue slime that was kind of jiggly, so I was super excited. I let it sit after I stirred it up, and this is what it looked like, you guys. The water kind of separated from the slime, but it did feel like slime, but it was super sticky. And I think the reason for that is because dish soap is not the best for soap slime because it is really runny. Tell me in the comments below if you think this was a success or a fail. This recipe I actually just made up on the spot, and I wanted to see if it works. So you're gonna be needing two shampoos, the Suave shampoo and the Tea Tree Tingle Trader Joe's shampoo body wash. Add both soaps to the bowl. I added in an even ratio of both soaps. And then you have to add in your water. So right here is my Fiji water. Just add it in. And after you have added in your water, you just want to let this sit for a minute and stir it all up. This is what it looked like. It was so jiggly. And then you want to put this in the refrigerator. Sorry, my lighting darkened up a lot. It took me like an hour for this to be in the refrigerator, so my lighting is a lot darker. But this recipe was a success, and I was actually not expecting it to work as well as it did. So I was super happy. If you guys test this recipe, tell me in the comments down below if it worked for you. And thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you guys tomorrow as I am daily uploading, and soon I will be doing my face reveal, so don't forget to subscribe. Love you guys. Bye.